over. Top of the head of the rib. And the head of the rib are most of the ribs. Has crest.
Crista.
Capitis.
Costa. Which ribs have not got this head, this crest?
1, 11, 12.
First 11, 10, 12. Because these ribs joint with complete fossa on corresponding vertebrae. That is why first joint between ribs and vertebral column, that is joint between head of the rib and costal facets on the bodies of the vertebrae. And most of these joints are compound because one rib in most cases joined with two nearest vertebrae, except first, 11th and 12th. These rejoins are simple. It is first rib joined with forward costalis of the first thoracic vertebrae, 11th and 12th the same joint with complete fossa on corresponding vertebrae. First, 11th and third joints are simple, all another compound. Next, all of these joints are spheroid joints. In theory, they should be multi-axial, but they combine together with another joint between tubercle of the rib and transverse process. And these joints are cylindrical. That is why all of these joints together are uniaxial, the same like
atlas and axis.
Between atlas and axis, you're right. One again. Articulatio capitis costa, between head of the rib and costal facets on the bodies. They are simple in first, 11th and 12th, or compound in all another joints. They are spheroid and uniaxial and combined. These joints has two types of ligaments. One ligament is inside of this joint, intra-articular ligament, and only compound joints has intra-articular ligament. This ligament start from crest, crista capitis costa, and attach to discus intervertebralis. That is why first, 11th and 12th joints have not got this ligament, only joints from second to 10th. Name of this ligament, ligamentum capitis costa intra-articulare. Intra-articular ligament of the head of the rib. Another joint is extra-articular. It's present in all 12 joints. It is ligamentum capitis costa radiatum. Radiatum. It's from head of the rib. Goes in all directions and attached to bodies of the vertebra, ligamentum capitis costa radiatum. Next joint, I already said that is joint between fovea costalis processus transversus, that is costal facet on transverse process, and tubercle of the rib. Articulatio costo transversaria, costa transversaria. That is simple, always simple. Cylindrical of the first type, uniaxial and combined joint. Only one type of movements, ribs can move upward and downward in frontal axis. That is frontal axis, and ribs can move upward and down. In case when a ribs moves upward, that is breathing, that is
Inspiration
in time of inspiration, and when the ribs moves downward, it is expiration. Yes. Joint between tubercle and transverse process is the same, has one ligament, ligamentum costo transversarium. Name of this ligament is the same like name of this joint. Next joint, it is joint between ribs and sternum. Here it is articulatio sternocostalis. All of them are simple because two articular surfaces. They are plain. They also combine together with if ribs moves, here it is. It's the same movement. here. That is why these three joints, articulatio capitis cost, articulatio costo transversari, and articulatio sternocostalis, they combine together. That is why all of them are uniaxial joints. And again, simple, plain, combined, and uniaxial. It is the same, we can see ligamenta sternocostalia radiata here and here and here, and these ligaments on anterior surface of sternum makes membrane, membrana sterni, that is membrane which forms with the help of ligamenta sternocostalia radiata, that is membrane. First rib, usually fused with sternum with the help of cartilage, that is seen chondrosis, sternocostalis between first rib and sternum. 8th, 9th, and 10th ribs, anteriorly cartilages of these ribs, false ribs, joined with cartilage of the upper rib, and in place where two nearest cartilages join together, we have articulatio interchondralis, chondros, that is cartilage, articulatio interchondralis, that is joints between cartilages of the nearest ribs. They are the same, simple, plain, uniaxial combined joints, like joints between sternum and ribs. What else? Some words about joint between clavicle and sternum. Sternoclavicular joint. It is simple joint. It is clear because two bones join together. It is saddle joint. Saddle. In theory, saddle joint is biaxial, but it is the same like in temporomandibular joint. We have intra-articular cartilage, discus articularis. This discus articularis separate cavities of this joint into two halves. That is why it is complex joint. It's also combined because clavicle moves between, sternoclavicular joint work together with acromioclavicular joint. Clear it is. And it is multi-axial joint, multi-axial, not biaxial, but multi-axial. And again, simple, saddle, complex, with the help of this, combined, because two joints work together, and multi-axial. Which movements is possible? Here it is. In sagittal axis, we can move clavicle upward and down. In vertical axis, we can move clavicle forward and backward. And in it is not frontal, it is axis which correspond to the axis of clavicle. It's possible to make rotation of clavicle in a small volume, but it is possible to not make video. What can I use your hand? If you move your hand backward and this movement, in this case clavicle, it's rotate. That is, if I move my head backward in clavicle, rotate downward and upward. That is rotation of clavicle. Three types of movement, three axes of movement. And ligaments, here it is. First ligament between sternum and the clavicle, ligamentum sternoclaviculare anterior and ligamentum sternoclaviculare posterior. Then, between both clavicles, above of jugular notch, we have in the ligamentum interclaviculare, interclavicular ligament, ligamentum interclaviculare. And last ligament between first rib and clavicle, ligamentum costoclaviculare, here it is. And last joint, that is joint between clavicle and acromion end of scapula, the same, we have one good scapula, but everything is the same. It is simple, it is saddle, acromioclavicular joint is ellipsoid. It also has cartilage inside discus articularis, that is why it's also complex. and it is combined because they work together, and multiaxial, the same movements are like in sternoclavicular joint because they work together. And ligaments, ligamentum acromioclavicularis and ligamentum coracoclavicularis, two ligaments necessary to know, acromioclavicular ligament and coracoclavicular ligament. This ligament starts from coracoid process and attach to tuberculum conoidum, if you remember in clavicle, tuberculum conoidum of clavicle,
surface.
Yes, on the inferior surface, yes. That is all. Please.
So there's a difference between the first rib articulation and the rest of the articulations, right?
First is not synovial,
the other
is
synovial.
Yes, there is no space between sternum and first rib, that is cartilage fused together with sternum. That is why it is permanent synchondrosis. In all in other places, we have articular cavities, articular bursa, and
they're subdivided
surfaces.
Into two.
It is joints. It is synchondrosis.
So these are like divided into two.
No. They're not subdivided. That is why these joints are not complex. They are simple, plain. Combined and uniaxial.
Okay, thank you.
Something else? It is all. Articulation of the ribs and joints of the clavicle. Sternoclavicular and acromioclavicular joints.
There is only permanent synchondrosis in...
Yes, permanent synchondrosis. Between parts of the sternum, you remember, manubrium, corpus, and xiphoid process. We have... temporary synchondrosis, and the same year of age of 18, these three parts fused in one bone, sternum.
Mm-hmm.
Synchondrosis replaced with synostosis, but permanent synchondrosis between first rib and sternum.
Mm-hmm.
Well, today that is all.